enteric bacteria.
But we're running in, we're, granted also, one of your controls was Staphylococcus aureus. And when on your unknown, you will run either a full MVIC, if you have a gram negative, you'll order that. If not, you will order the VP test. And you can tell differences between those three gram positives with that. So you're gonna add 5 drops of methyl red indicator. And what happens with this, you have to give that tube a little, after you've added your 5 drops, take that tube and do this. Otherwise, I've noticed that it was just sitting on top of the medium. It's red, but it's sitting on top of the medium. So just don't do this with the indol, but with the methyl red, you do that so that it goes throughout the medium. Post-posterior test. And identifies organisms that are able to produce acetoin, and that isn't acetone, it's acetoin, T-O-I-N, from grating glucose during a 2,3-butanediol fermentation. We are going to use 2 reagents with this one. And they get added in order. First one we're going to use is alpha naphthol. The second one is potassium creatinine. If the reagents oxidize the acetoin, so if your bacteria was able to produce acetoin, those reagents will oxidize it and it will produce a red color. And then it would be a positive reaction. In other words, the acetoin would have had to have been produced by the bacteria. So here's how we do it. 5 drops of alpha naphthol solution. Then you add 5 drops of potassium creatinine. Then you are going to shake that tube very well for 1 minute. You got your lid, put your lid on, push it down. Put your thumb on top of it, because you know those lids aren't airtight. I usually have the students take the lid off and put their thumb over it with a glove on it and shake away. About 1 minute, and when I say shake, I don't mean that. I mean that. Like that. Oops. And then you have to wait before you read it. So you're gonna wait at least 20 minutes before you read it. And afterwards, if you let it sit long enough, it will turn that color, but at the beginning, it's not all that red, but you can see in the bubbles after you've shaken and it sat there for a while, you can see that there's red tints around. Whereas if it's negative, you're not gonna see that, you just see bubbles. Simmer citrate, that is used to determine, can that bacteria use the only source of carbon that Karen put in the media, which is citrate. So as its sole source of carbon, because we didn't put anything else in. So on this one, hopefully you took a picture of your, remember there's 2 tubes for this. One is the Cosers. The Cosers, what you will be looking for is, did your bacteria grow? So how would you know that? You look at that media with the Cosers, we're just seeing, did your bacteria grow? Was it able to grow? So how would you know?
It's turbid.
Turbid. Turbidity. So if your bacteria settled out, you can give it a little shake and you'll see. So that's that one. But on the slant, originally it was green. And we have a dye in there called bromethymol blue.
pH 7.6. And that dye is used as a pH indicator. As the pH goes up in the media, then it changes from green to blue. Blue indicates a positive reaction. However, nothing is black and white in the lab. So, sometimes it stays green, but when you look at it, you'll see this kind of rust-colored growth on there. That's your bacteria growing. For some reason, it didn't change it. So either the media turns blue and it's positive, or you see some growth on there, and it will be rust-colored in the media. So here's your, over here is your original, what your media originally looked at, looked like. It's green, and this one, the bacteria caused it to go to alkaline and it turned blue. And you don't have to copy this stuff. Triple sugar iron auger was another one you did. You stabbed all the way to the bottom with this. This has three different sugars in it. We have 1% of with lactose and 1% with sucrose. But we only put in 0.1% of glucose. You'll see why that is. We have a pH indicator in there, that's phenol red. And we have ferrous sulfate in there. So this media can this media will be able to show you if your bacteria was able to form hydrogen sulfide because it'll be a black precipitate. So we stabbed all the way to the bottom. So if this slant will allow anaerobic things to grow in it. We went all the way to the bottom. So that butt part, we call it butt or slant. The butt part provides anaerobic growth. Reactions are written on the slant to butt reaction. So we're looking at color changes. So you know your media was red when you started out. If you have a red, that means a red slant and a red butt, there was no change, no fermentation took place, and you have alkaline condition. Please. If you have a red slant and a yellow butt, that means that only the glucose fermented. We don't have a lot of glucose in there. We only have 0.1% compared to the other two. So what originally happens is if after 24 hours we were there and looked at it, this is a bacteria that only do the glucose, the whole thing would be yellow. But because we have so little glucose in there, then it starts going after proteins that are in there, and then that slant goes back to the red color. So red slant, yellow, but glucose was the only sugar that was fermented. If you have a yellow slant and a yellow butt, you have fermentation of both the glucose and the lactose and the sucrose, and you have acidic conditions. Let's look at this. Let's start with this guy. What happened?
There's no fermentation.
No fermentation. That's red slant, red butt. How about this guy?
Glucose only.
Glucose only. We got a red slant and a yellow butt. After 24 hours, it was all yellow like this, but then it starts going back to alkaline conditions and the bacteria starts using the protein. Can you see what that? Oh no, let's do that. This one, what happened?
Fermentation.
Oh, what? What does this mean? What made this clear spot down here?
Oxygen.
What pushed the media up?
Gas.
Gas. It produced gas. So we don't see it as a bubble like we did in the Durham tube. But it either can make cracks in the media, or if it's a big gas producer, it can raise the whole thing up. Which one of the bacteria that we've had is a big gas producer? E. coli. Yeah. Now let's go to this one. What color?
Black.
Black butt. And what's this lab? Red. Okay. Anytime you see this black in your media, that's that black precipitate of hydrogen sulfide, you can assume that it would be yellow if that wasn't there. So this one also would be a glucose fermenter, but at the same time, this organism was able to produce the hydrogen sulfide precipitate.
Nitrogen or hydrogen?
Hydrogen sulfide. Is what it produces. Sims media, that was a littler tube. It was an auger tube in the form of a yeet, meaning it was straight across. We stabbed that one halfway down. And you were careful not to wiggle your loop. Because the very first thing, this one will check for, this is a good media. It checks for hydrogen sulfide production, it checks for motility, and we can also check indole production on this. So the first thing you're gonna check though, you're gonna check for motility. So you made a stab line that went down and you back up again. So you're going to check to see if your bacteria moved away from that stab line. And if they did, what do they have?
Flagella.
That's how bacteria move. Second thing you're going to check for, you're going to check for that black precipitate. After you're finished looking at all that, then we can check for indole. So you're gonna do it the same way you did in the broth. You're gonna add 5 drops of Provax reagent, and then you're gonna look for that red line on the top. And you only have one bacteria that is, you know, produces the indole.
There's three.
Well, I'm not gonna tell. You'll find out this week. Okay. Oh no, I'll do that later. Go ahead and take a break.